Welcome, welcome, dear student. In one another session, myself, Darshana Sandeep Shinde from KKVAG Institute of Pharmacy, Chandori, Nashik. Our today's discussion topic is Introduction to the Central Nervous System. Learning outcomes of our today's sessions are: students should be able to understand and recognize the classification of central nervous system, anatomy of central nervous system, physiology of central nervous system, and functions of the various parts of the central nervous system. Let's start our session and discuss all the points one by one. First of all, we see the physiology of or anatomy of the central nervous system, or what is the anatomy of our CNS. This is our brain. Brain has a mainly four parts: frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe, temporary lobe. Here is a pons, middle of Langata. Here is the cerebellum, and this is the thalamus and hypothalamus and all other parts. This is necessary to understand the anatomy of the brain. We have to understand the actual position of the brains, each and every parts. So let's start discussion. In the anatomy of central nervous system, that is the It is a nervous system in higher animal and can be divided into central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Anatomy of the brain divided into two parts: central nervous system and peripheral nervous system, on the basis of the anatomical consideration. Then, the central nervous system consists of a brain and spinal cord. Then, the peripheral nervous system, that is another part of the our brain. That is, a peripheral nervous system consists of nerves outgoing from the efferent system and incoming to the central nervous system. Those which carry the impulses to the central nervous system from the main efferent system and carry the impulses and gland from the efferent systems. Here we have to understand what is the peripheral nervous system. It involves the afferent system and efferent system. Afferent means it consists of a nerve outgoing from the central nervous afferent system and incoming to the central nervous system. That is, nerves coming to the central nervous system is the afferent system, and efferent means, that means these are the carrying impulses to the muscles and the gland. Then efferent nerves carrying the impulses to the skeletal muscles, that is motor nerves. It carries the nerves or impulses to the skeletal muscles, that is motor nerves, and name as the somatic nerves. That nerves which carry the impulses to the skeletal muscles are known as the somatic nerves. And then efferent nerves carrying the impulses to the smooth muscles and the gland. That is autonomic nervous system, that is also known as the ANS. Efferent system also carries the impulses to the smooth muscles and the glands. And then there are two divisions of ANS. That is a autonomic nervous system has a two division. That is a sympathetic nervous system, SNS, and parasympathetic nervous system. Central nervous system consists of a brain and spinal cord. The main parts of the brain are cerebrum, diencephalon, brain stem, and cerebellum. These are the four parts of the brain. And our CNS consists of a brain and spinal cord. First of all, we see the classification of the nervous system. Nervous system is divided into two parts. The first one is the central nervous system and other one is the peripheral nervous system. Again, this peripheral nervous system is divided into two parts. First one is afferent system and second one is the efferent system. Then again, this efferent system is divided into two parts, that is somatic nerves and atomic nervous system. This atomic nervous system is divided into again two parts, that is sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. This is all the classification of the our nervous system. Then we see the physiology of central nervous system. In the physiology, we have see the first of all the functions of various parts of the nervous system. Central nervous system. First of all, first part of our central nervous system is cerebrum. Cerebrum, in the cerebrum, it is divided into three to four parts. First one is the cerebral cortex. In the cerebrum, there is a cerebral cortex, which is a motor area in the cerebral cortex, govern the muscular movement. Cerebral cortex govern the muscular movement. Sensory area is concerned with the interpretation of the sensory impulses. Here the cerebral cortex, there is a interpretation of the sensory impulses. It is associated, or it is an association area, are concerned with the emotional and intellectual processes. Here in the cerebral cortex, emotional and intellectual processes are carried out. Then basal ganglia is the second part of the cerebrum. It help in the control of the muscular movement. For the muscular movement control from the basal ganglia. Then limbic system. It is found that the cerebral hemisphere and the diencephalon, it is a function in the emotional aspects of behavior and memory. Limbic system has a function of the emotional aspects of behavior and memory. This one is the third part of our cerebrum. Then second part of our central nervous system is diencephalon. It consists of a thalamus and hypothalamus. Thalamus, it contains the nuclei that act as a relay station for the sensor. It has a nuclei which act as a relay sensor for the sorry station for the sensor. Then second part is a hypothalamus. Diencephalon's second part is a hypothalamus. It controls the ANS. It also controls the body temperature. This hypothalamus also controls the body temperature, regulates the food and fluid intake, maintain the waking state and sleep pattern. All these important functions of our body are carried out through the hypothalamus. That is body temperature regulation of body temperature, controlation of body temperature, regulate the food and fluid intake, maintain the walking state and sleeping patterns. The next functions of this is the diagram of our brain, which show the different functions are carried out by the different region. This is the speech, smell, and then concentrating and planning, problem solving, motor control. These are controlled by the frontal lobe. Then touch and pressure, taste, body temperature are controlled by the parietal lobe. Then language, reading is concerned with the all the three parts, that is a parietal lobe, temporary lobe, and this is between that area. And hearing and facial recognition is carried out by the temporal lobe. And then coordination of different body parts, it is carried out from the cerebrum. Then after the thalamus, diencephalon is divided into two parts, thalamus and hypothalamus. Then third part of our central nervous system is brain stem. It consists of a midbrain, pons, veroli and medulla oblongata. Then we see the pons veroli. It relates impulses from the cerebral cortex to the cerebrum, related to the voluntary skeletal movement. To reticular formulation of the pons helps to control the respiration. This is the pons veroli function, that is to helps to control the respiration. Then midbrain, it connect the pons and diencephalon. Midbrain connect the pons and diencephalon. It regulate the auditory and visual reflexes. Visual reflexes, auditory reflexes are controlled by the midbrain. Then the medulla oblongata, it contain the nuclei that are reflex center for the regulation of the heart rate, respiration rate, vasoconstriction, swallowing, coughing, omitting and sneezing. All these are important functions are carried out through the medulla oblongata. Then fourth part of our brain stem, that is cerebellum, it coordinates the skeletal muscles, maintain the normal muscle tone, and body equilibrium. That means functions associated with our muscles, brain, and then tone of muscle is carried out by the cerebellum. These are the four types of the brain stem and their functions. Then last part is our brain, that is spinal cord. It reflects involved in reflex movements and control of muscle tone is also a function regulated by the spinal cord. Then we see the drugs affect the central nervous system in various ways. Drugs may act directly or by the neurons, the modifying the neural function. Or second way, the some drugs act reflexly by sending the afferent impulses to the central nervous system via the chemoreceptor, baroreceptor, peripheral nerves, causing thereby the psychic, somatic, then visceral responses. There are the drugs, various drugs which act on the brain or central nervous system by the two modes. First one is by modifying the neuronal function, and second one by system is sending their reflexes via chemoreceptor, baroreceptor, and then peripheral nerves. Some drugs may affect the nutrition and oxygen supply of the neuron by altering the blood supply or affecting their metabolism. Thus, the drug either stimulate or depress the central nervous system. There are the drugs which are responsible for the stimulation of the central nervous system, and some drugs are responsible for the depression of the central nervous system. First of all, we see what is meant by drug stimulants. Stimulation of central nervous systems results from the suppression of the inhibiting areas in the central nervous system. The central stimulants are used to produce specific stimulation of the certain areas. That means central nervous system stimulants used to produce specific stimulation of the central areas. Example of it, sensory and motor cortex, medullary. Central stimulants are increases the central nervous system secretions. Then second one is the central depressant. Central depressant or depression of central nervous system can be achieved by releasing the inhibitory function of the chemical substances, interfering the synapse without including the structure. The depressant depress the irritability of the centers of the conspicuous perception or of the voluntary movements, finally leading to the temporary reversible loss of the conspicuousness, or known as the necrosis. In the depression, there is a reversible process where is a sometime patient lost their conspicuousness, which is known as the necrosis, and it is the mainly central depression mainly associated with the inhibition of the chemical substances, and in stimulants there is suppression of the inhibiting areas. Summary of our today's session is, in this session we learn the classification of central nervous system, anatomy of central nervous system, physiology of central nervous system, and functions of the various parts of the central nervous system. Thank you. Thank you for listening me. If you have any queries, this is my mail ID, then contact me.